So very good morning to all. So today we are going to discuss our new module. So we finished the morphology completely, and now we are going to discuss our very important part, that is taxonomy. We now know the basics of taxonomy. In order to study taxonomy, what we need is fundamentally we need is morphology, that you already discussed, you already studied well. And now we are going to discuss a very important part of the taxonomy, that is plant systematics. It's a fundamental and very important aspect is the classification. So let us pass on to the classification. Okay, so in before that, what is actually taxonomy? So it is a science of classifying organism. Okay, the word taxonomy was first proposed by A.P. Decantol. From the word taxonomy, M-I-E, in 1813, and taxonomy in 1819, proposed by Decantol. Okay, and the word originated from Greek words taxis, meaning arrangement. So arrangement, for why we are arranging, why we are grouping them, it is very easy for us to study and understand. Clear? For example, when you visit a textile showroom, you can see the different types of dresses in different sessions. Why they are arranged so? Very easy to take out and very easy to distribute and everything. So here it is actually arranged like a library or a showroom for easy study, and for somewhat similar characters are making together in a group likewise. So arrangement for making everything easier. That is the basic below the principle of classification. Okay. The term systematics, you can also call it as plant systematics, originated from Greek word systema, also applied to system of classification. Clear? Then Simpson, a very famous taxonomist, defined as scientific study of the kind and diversity of organism in all relationship. It's a scientific study. Not only plants, I just merely say plants and animals, not like that. Detailed scientific study, that is taxonomy. Understood? Now, it involves relationship between plants and their evolution. That's very, very important. So, how angiosperm originated? From where it originated? So, based on the what are the relationship between the two groups? Based on that, actually, it is arranged. That is very important aspects of taxonomy or systematics. That is relationship between plants and their evolution. Then, plant taxonomy also deals with handling of plant specimens. That's also very important. And also it is a branch of biology, deals with description, identification, classification and naming. Clear? Description. So you know how to describe a plant. Then you have to know how to identify a plant. And you know how to classify a plant. What are the categories? Which group, which family it is, which order it is, which genera, which species. So you have to classify it. Then you have to name it. These are the different aspects coming under taxonomy. What are they? Description, classification, identification and naming. Understood? Okay. So, first one, history and system of classification of plants. So, from where this actually the system of classification started? It has a long history. So, you know, pre-illiterate mankind, when man not know how to write, how to read, etc., in that time, actually what they did is only they have to know whether a plant can be able to eat, which of the plants should be avoided, which of them are poisonous, which of them used to cure diseases, so which of them are utilized as shelter. Likewise, only basic needs, they are thinking only about that. That is a pre-illiterate man. They are known as folk taxonomist. Clear? So, information accumulated and stored in human brain. No, there is no way to communicate here. That is the first pre-literate mankind. The basics, the history starts, taxonomy starts from pre-literate mankind. Okay. Then, after that, it is coming under the medieval botany, medieval age, progress for botanical investigation. The maximum work held at maximum workers or taxonomist or those people who are interested in this field is from Europe and Asia. Okay, then while discussing all thing, we have to remember the name Theophrastus, known as the father of botany. Clear? He is a Greek philosopher also and wrote 200 manuscripts, and his enquiry into plant is very important one. And he described about 500 kinds of plant. You think, remember, that is 372 BC to 287 BC. Clear? And he classified plants into four major groups. What are they? Trees, shrubs, subshrubs and herbs. It's a very simple classification. So, there onwards started classifying plants. Okay. And he recognizes difference between flowering and non-flowering plants. Like our, now we are calling it as angiosperms, gymnosperms, bryophytes, etc. So, no name given, but he know how to differentiate them. And also recognized superior ovary and inferior ovary, free and fused petals, and fruit types, etc. So, Theophrastus actually gave the foundation for taxonomy. Clear? Then Islamic botany, another an era where 610 to 1100 AD, a revival of literacy. In that time, Greek manuscripts were translated. So, in the Greek manuscripts, when you check out, you can see there are many plants described based on the sexuality and role of insects in pollination likewise. But no scientific way of classification here. So, this is the 15th century Arabic edition of Dioscorides Herbal. Okay, in picture in that time. Okay, now next. In the history while discussing, you have to remember Theophrastus that I already told you, father of botany, and Pliny, another important one, scientist. He published a work in Historia Naturalis. Then Dioscorides, another important, they are going together with Pliny, and he is an usual traveler, visited many places for collecting medicinal plants and studying medicinal plants, and he published a book, Materia Medica. Okay, then next comes Bohin, very important taxonomist. Two, they are brothers actually, brother Jean Bohin and Gaspard Bohin, two are there. Okay, so they wrote a book, Historia Plantarum Universalis. They are all in they are Latinized or in Greek, that's why. Historia Plantarum Universalis, and three botanical treaties also they published. Clear? Then John Ray, famous naturalist. You studied his contributions in the theory of evolution. Okay. And he studied many plants and also tried proposed a system of classification also, John Ray. According to him, there are two major taxa, dicotyledons and monocotyledons. Clear? No. Another very, very, very important, and also in the history of taxonomy, you have to always remember who Carl Linnaeus, Carolus Linnaeus or Carl Linnaeus, Swedish naturalist, actually given a concept to study of plants. Clear? 1707 to 1778. Clear? He proposed the classification and published in Systema Naturae. Very important book to remember always, Systema Naturae by Linnaeus. And he used character of stamens for describing and for classifying them. And according to him, there are 20 classes based on nature of stamens. Okay. Divided plant kingdom into 20 classes according to nature of stamens. Then Species Plantarum is the first edition in 1753. Containing description. So, very important, his Species Plantarum 1753 given all importance. Then, objectives of taxonomy. So, first part we studied history of taxonomy. Now, we are going to discuss objectives, goals or aims. Why we study taxonomy? Mainly to provide an inventory of plant taxa for local, regional and continental needs. Clear? So, in for example, in Kerala, a plant namely Rauwolfia serpentina, Sarpagandhi, a very important medicinal plant. Okay. So, we call it as Sarpagandhi. But when you visit another place, another name, local language. So, regional, local or different, it may vary. But there need an uniform scientific name for all of this. There is a role of what? Taxonomy. So, nomenclature. Then, one had to identify a particular plant. What was it? So, easily distinguish. We can easily identify a plant and we can use it medicinally. if we know everything regarding the particular plant. And also identification, nomenclature, description, then classification of for classification into order, family, genera and species, and also information concerning medicinal species, endangered species, conservation status, unique plants, everything we will get while studying plant taxonomy. Clear? Then scope of taxonomy, I already told, oldest science, provide thorough knowledge on living species, very important, and all branches depend on taxonomy. So for example, when a student is studying his aim is to prepare a medicine from a plant. So first, what he want to know, the plant is its scientific name. Is the plant is the required one? So how he will check it? For that he need a taxonomy. For example, if a person want to study the medicinal aspects of the common plant Shavannari, you know, Catharanthus roseus or Vinca roseus. Okay, so in order to study that plant, first he need its scientific name and its description, then only he can go into the pharmaceutical aspects. So for every branch there need first what, taxonomy. Okay, and also another branches like cytogenetics, phytochemistry, etc. for proper computation. Then next is types of biological classification. What are the different types of biological classification? First one is the main system is natural system, artificial system and phylogenetic system. Artificial, natural and phylogenetic system. These are the three types of biological classification. First one is artificial system. Okay, first one is artificial system. So what is the always for examination these questions may be arising. What is artificial system? System based on one or two superficial characters only, without considering any morphological details or phylogenetic relationship. Means here only few characters are taken for classification. They are not considering any other morphological features and also phylogenetic relationship, means evolutionary relationship between the plants or groups or like that. Clear? An artificial system is one in which plants classify according to a few characters. That's very important. Description or not related to the affinity or relationship. Linnaeus system, sexual system is an example of artificial system. Okay. Then all classes prior to Linnaeus is also artificial. What are the merits? First attempt of classification is by this system. Okay. And demerit is not based on all characters and also distant species and close species might be placed together. That's a main demerit, related and distant species in one group. Then evolutionary aspects not discussing. That's a demerit. Then this is the person Carolus Linnaeus and his book Species Plantarum. Actually his classification is artificial one. Clear? Okay. Now natural system, second one. Here classification based on several natural characters. Okay. In the first case, only few one or two characters and several characters. Here, another peculiar feature is, while classifying, simplest one is placed at the first, while complex one at the last part of the system. Okay. Example is Bentham and Hooker system. That is, who is Bentham? George Bentham, a scientist, and J.D. Hooker, another scientist. So, both together published a classification and that you have to study, and that is natural system. Okay. And morphological characters are taken, but several morphological characters are taken into consideration. But in artificial system, only few characters are taken into consideration. And plants are arranged according to these morphological characters. Clear? Even in the botanical gardens and herbarias, plants are arranged according to Bentham and Hooker system of classification. So you have to study the example of natural system. What is that? Bentham and Hooker system of classification. Now, this is Bentham and Hooker, George Bentham and Joseph Hooker, and their book Genera Plantarum. So what is the book of Linnaeus? Species Plantarum. Bentham and Hooker is Genera Plantarum. Clear? Now, system of classification before Darwin are natural systems. I already told they are natural systems. So I given directly, but here the merits are mainly a description based on several characters. Clear? And another one is, it is widely accepted classification. Demerit is that wrongly placed, some gymnosperms wrongly placed between dicots and monocots. So broader classification of Bentham and Hooker is dicotyledone, gymnosperms and monocot, three division. Clear? So gymnosperm in between dicot and monocot is not a satisfactory. That is a very important one. Then some having a system with the closely related are placed distantly, but not together, but distant are placed together. That is one more demerit. Okay. Now, third one is phylogenetic system. What is phylogenetic system? This system of classification is based on evolutionary relationship. Understood? It is largely accepted by biologists. And this system tried to explain the relationship of plants and organisms while arranging how they originated also. And a very important one. Example is Eichler, Engler, Rindel, Hutchinson. But they are all phylogenetic system. Merits is phylogenetic relationship is explained. Example, Adolf Engler, then Prandtl and Hutchinson. Two, three scientists. So you have to write the example of this last phylogenetic system. So what are the three types? Natural, artificial, phylogeny. Natural one, example Linnaeus, species Plantarum. Artificial. Natural example is Bentham and Hooker classification, genera Plantarum. Then phylogeny example, Engler, Prandtl system, Hutchinson, etc. Now, so a brief account of all these systems is very important. First one is Linnaeus system. In 18th century, Linnaeus published a system of classifying plants. 18th century, okay. And Linnaeus published Systema Naturae, his work in Systema Naturae, okay. And also he have three kingdoms. How did he divide the groups? Three kingdoms. And they are again divided into classes. Then classes again divided into orders, then into families, then genera and species. Okay. Very important as the use of binomial nomenclature. That is a very peculiar feature of Linnaeus system. He introduced binomial nomenclature. What is that? For every name, there are two parts. A generic part epithet and a specific epithet. Generic name and a specific name. For example, shoe flower. Hibiscus rosa sinensis. Hibiscus is a generic part. Rosa sinensis is a species part. So, Linnaeus introduced binomial system. He published Systema Naturae. And he published the species Plantarum, etc. Okay. Then, Linnaean name or scientific name, two parts I already discussed. While writing generic name, you should start with the capital letters, then other small letters. And if you are writing printing, you have to that in italics. If not, if writing, just underline both the words. A broad category of Linnaeus system is what? Plant kingdom and animal kingdom. So these are some examples. Linnaeus 20 classes actually he divided. Class 1 is Monandria, based on the stamens, flower with one stamen, Diandria, Triandria, etc. like 20. Okay. The next is Engler and Prandtl. What is the system of Engler and Prandtl? Engler and Prandtl is the last system, phylogenetic system. According to them, they are the German botanist and they published a book, Naturlichen, Pflanzen, Familie. The book is known as Naturlichen, Pflanzen, Familie. Systema Naturae is the book of Linnaeus. His classification, how it is classified, entire kingdom of from algae to angiosperms into 13 divisions. So, algae to angiosperms into 13 divisions. So, plant kingdom include 3 divisions, 11, 12, 13. Others are all algae, fungi, etc. First 11 division is what? Thallophytes, algae, fungi, likewise. Then 11 to 13 is the plant system. Okay. 12 division, 12th one is the embryophyta division. Then you can have division thallophyta 11, 12, embryophyta 13 also, embryophyta siphonogamma, 12 is embryophyta hyphogamma. Okay. Then he divided 13th division, in 13th part he divided embryophyta into what? two groups, seed plants, that is two subdivisions. What are they? Gymnosperma and the angiosperma. Embryophyta into two groups, gymnosperma and angiosperma. 12 is what? Embryophyta, acigo, gamma. What is that? Bryophyta and pteridophyta. Okay, here division to embryophyta into divided into seed plants. What are the gymnosperma and the angiosperma? Okay, subdivision angiosperm again divided into classes. What are they? Angiosperm into monocots and dicots. They again divided. This is a system by Engler and Prandtl. Plant kingdom into divisions up to the division of 10. What is 11? The first 11 division is system. First 11 division is what? System of classification of thallophytes. 13 divisions actually. Okay. Then groups of dicots, monocots, last one. There, Wendham-Hooker system, I already told it is a natural system. He published in Genera Plantarum. Wendham, a well-known English botanist. Hooker, a well-known botanist of and also director of Royal Botanical Garden, Kew. And according to them, there are two notary. They divided the flowering plants, seed flowering plants into two notary families, grouped into cohorts or orders. Total number of species, 97,000. Then one more classification is APG system, that is angiosperm phylogeny group, latest classification. This all around the world, there are a team of taxonomists. They work together and they proposed APG strictly based on the evolutionary relationships and molecular studies. That is very important. Not only morphological features, but molecular studies are conducted. DNA sequencing is conducted in order to study the relationships among plants and grouped them. That is angiosperm phylogeny group or APG, first published in 2018. That's very recent one. Okay. So APG 4 is the latest one. APG 1, 2, 3 and 4 is the latest one. For having 64 angiosperm order and 416 family. How much? 64 angiosperm and 416 family. Families are grouped into monophyletic orders. What are the groups? Monocots, commelinoids, eudicots, core eudicots, rosids, urosid 1, urosid 2, astrids, euastrids 1, euastrids 2. Just remember this. And this is for brief questions only, not essay type. So what are the three? Linnaeus system, Engelram-Prandtl system, APG system. Artificial system by Linnaeus, natural system by Wendham-Hooker, phylogeny by Engler and Prandtl, then latest angiosperm phylogeny group or APG system. Okay. So I hope today we discussed history of classification, what is taxonomy, what are the different classification under taxonomy, natural, artificial and phylogeny, and examples for Linnaeus, Engler and Prandtl, then APG and everything for that. And how can you differentiate artificial and natural? Natural only based on some of the characters. Artificial, some more characters. Phylogeny, the relationship or evolutionary relationship is studied. So, hope clear this first introductory part and the classification part. Now, we will discuss the Bentham and Hooker system of classification in detail. That question may be asked for examination, essay questions also. Okay, thank you.